Hi friends, thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you've enjoyed our other videos and that you'll have just as much fun today. We're going to be doing yoga, which means breathing, moving, and working with our mind. For today, our word is svadhyaya. Another hard word to say, but an easy word to explain. Go ahead, let's try to say it together. Svadhyaya. Cool, thanks for trying. What does svadhyaya mean? It means that we should always be learning. Like my teddy bear friends over here, they're learning by reading books. What ways do you learn? Thanks for sharing. Something we can learn about besides books, besides things that are happening outside of us is learning about ourselves. So when you're doing yoga and you take a breath in, you learn how it feels in your body. And when you move your arm and your hand and you breathe as you move, you learn. You learn how it feels to open your hand big or even balance on one leg. That's all learning. And svadhyaya means a commitment to learning about yourself. So as you practice yoga today, whether you do all of it at once or break it up into little pieces, I encourage you to continue thinking about svadhyaya. What are you learning about yourself? Have a great time. Are you ready to breathe? This is called the complete breath. It starts in your nose, heads down to your belly, and then comes up into your chest. Here we go. Good example, Lucille. All right, we're gonna try it together. Let all the air out. Inhaling through your nose. Feel it in your belly, get big. Feel it in your chest, let it rise, and then let it come out of your chest. Out of your belly. Let's try it again. Inhale big. Belly, chest, and fall. Chest, belly, and release. All right, now go ahead and lie down. Put your teddy bear on your belly and see with your breath if you can bop your bear off. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, try it again. Big bellies, big breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Oh, that doesn't work. He has to be on his back. All right. Inhale. Exhale. Our bears are moving, but they're not rocking off. Let's try it one more time. Inhale. Exhale. We did it! All right, thank you. Hello, thank you for joining us for partner poses. Audra and I are gonna show you and invite you to do some partner poses with us. And remember, we're trying to think of svadhyaya. How can we learn about our body as we move it? So the first pose we're gonna do is boat pose. So go ahead and turn towards one another, sitting on the mat. Go ahead and scoot a little bit closer to me. There you go. You're gonna put your hands behind you and then try to touch your feet into each other. Good. Kind of find a balance. Maybe your hands go back pretty far. Maybe they're pretty close. You're trying to get your shoulders open and your back really flat. All right, from here, we're gonna each pick up one hand, doesn't matter which hand, and then try to touch. And then the other hand will wave. Hi. Ah. All right, let's try the other side. Hand is back. Touch, touch, touch. Wave, hello. All right, and then you can get fancy. You can have both arms lifted. Yikes. You can relax your shoulders back. Good, now let's try to straighten one leg.
You gotta straighten opposite legs or you'll push each other over. And let's try the other way. Good. All right, one more time. Hold steady in the center. Take a big breath in. As you breathe out, I want you to think in your body, where do you feel it the most? Awesome. All right, from here, we're going to move to bridge pose. So I'm going to start first. I'm going to lay on my back and have my back flat on the mat. I'm going to go ahead and place my hands next to my hips and then set my feet down onto the mat. From here, I'm going to go ahead and lift my hips up and feel a stretch. Now, I'm the bigger person, so I'm doing this type of a bridge. From here, Audra's going to go ahead and put her feet right on top of my knees and keep her tail and back on the mat. So go ahead and rest your tail down. Good job. And rest your head all the way down. All the way. There we go. Now, if she wants, she can lift her tail up because her shoulders and head are resting into the mat. Good. Let's take two breaths together. And one more here. Excellent. All right, let's go ahead and release that down. Now we're gonna try a variation of our stick pose. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn my back to Audra. I'm gonna straighten my legs way out in what we call stick pose or dandasana. And then she's gonna go ahead and scooch way up so that her tail meets my tail. Way close, way close. Good. Now she's gonna flip around and bring her legs on top of my back. Perfect. She's gonna rest her back all the way down onto the floor. I'm gonna scoot her in. It's very tickly for her. And then we're gonna take a big breath in together and a big breath out. I'm gonna raise my arms over my head. You can do this too along the floor. Inhale, reaching up and stretch through the whole body. You feel that shift? Good. And exhale, bring those hands back towards your hips. Good. The person on the floor can pretend they're making snow angels. Reaching, good. One more breath in. And one more breath out. All right, from here, I'm gonna get a bigger stretch by Audra pressing her legs into my body. And I'm gonna say, stop, that's far enough. And then I'm gonna straighten up and press her legs back into her chest. And she's gonna yell,
stop, that's enough.
And then I know not to press back any further. Let's try it one more time. Stop, that is enough.
That is enough.
Excellent. All right. Thank you so much for doing partner poses with us today.
Bye.
Hello, yoga friends. I'm looking forward to doing some yoga with you today. Let's start with being really playful so we can learn more about how our body feels. We're going to start with boat pose. Sitting on your tail, placing your hands behind you, keep your heels on the mat or see if you can lift them up. The goal here is to really reach long and tall with your back. And then if you want, go ahead and lift the arms too. Sometimes you can rock and feel yourself being extra playful. Letting your back tilt, letting your heels touch. Feeling like you're a boat in a really busy pool of water in an ocean. Oh my goodness, it's so rocky in this boat. Fun, right? All right, from here, you're gonna cross your feet and come into your cat-cow. Hands right underneath the shoulders, knees right underneath the hips. Tuck your chin down and scoop it up. And then curl your spine up to the ceiling like a cat. One more time, inhale. How does it feel? Exhale, round that spine. Go ahead and curl the toes. Walk your hands back to your knees. Can you steady balance on those toes? I'll show you another view. So my toes are touching, my knees are together, and I'm balancing my arms out to the side. From here, you're gonna reach up in
into a forward fold. So glue your hands onto your thighs, press your heels down as you straighten the legs, and you are in an L shape. Let's take two breaths here. And then we're gonna come into what we call an awkward chair. Keep the hands glued to those legs, press the knees forward, flatten the back out, and you are in what we call awkward chair. You can raise the arms up, you can keep them glued to your legs. Let's take two breaths. And then we're gonna come all the way back to that rocking boat. How are we gonna get there? We're gonna straighten into our L shape, our forward fold. We're gonna pop up our heels and balance onto those tippy toes. We're going to walk our hands out and do our cow with a breath in. Do our cow with a breath out. We're gonna cross our ankles, sit back on those sit bones and pop those heels up if our body allows us to. Do you wanna try something extra hard? Take your peace fingers, your two first fingers, grab onto your toes, and straighten your legs out. Whoa! Three, two, one, release. Oh, look, we're in that L shape again. Pretty fun. All right, from here, we're gonna try a twist. So we're gonna keep our legs glued to the ground just how they are and walk our hands over to the side. Tall with your spine and sweep all the way around. Can you look at me the other way? No, our backs don't work that way. Let's try twisting the other way. All right, go ahead. Glue your legs down to the mat. Sit tall with your spine. Twist over, look, 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 and go the other way. Could you see me? No, I didn't think so. All right, let's try our all the way up to standing and coming back down to the floor one more time. We're in boat pose. Breathing, having some fun. Maybe you're rocking. Maybe your heels are touching down. Do you remember what's next? Get to cat cow. Okay, here we go. Breathe in. Breathe out. Curl the toes, walk your hands back, balance on those tippy toes, and we straighten up into our forward fold. Hands are glued. And then bend in the knees, reach the arms up, awkward chair. Hold steady, can you, for two more breaths? Excellent. All right, all the way back down. Glue your hands, straighten into your forward fold. Lift up the heels into your balance. Carefully walk the hands down into your cow, into your cat. Cross at the ankles, find your boat pose. And then glue those long legs into the mat. Great job! And now it's time to end our yoga practice. Let's go ahead and wiggle our toes, wiggle our fingers, bring your shoulders up into your ears, and relax them down. For our closing today, we're going to do a practice called All Good Things. Let's try that now.
All good things rain down on me. All good things grow up through me. All good things surround me.
We'll try it one more time. All good things rain down on me. All good things grow up through me. All good things surround me. May all goodness be with you in the weeks ahead, And thank you again for doing yoga with us.
Bye.
These three books, Sloth at the Zoom, Peace, A Celebration of Mindfulness, and Here and Now, are all books I recommend. These books give you practical, easy ways to talk about mindfulness, which is a great tool when we're looking at slowing down or turning our attention inward versus pushing our attention and focus outward. I especially like how playful and practical these books are, and the pictures are, of course, stunning.